In this video demonstration, I will introduce you to the concept of the Oxygen Publishing Template, a feature designed to provide the ability to define all aspects of the layout and style of WebHelp responsive and PDF output for data documentation. It is especially helpful for those who are familiar with CSS and HTML5, since each type of transformation includes CSS and HTML5 processing stages. More specifically, in this video, I will show you how to use a built-in template as a starting point, and then make some CSS-based changes to customize the WebHelp and PDF output. The possible benefits for using a publishing template package include: you can use any of the existing built-in templates as a starting point for your customizations. The customized template packages are easy to share with others. Custom template packages remain intact even when you upgrade Oxygen to a new version. A publishing template can be easily integrated with a continuous integration publishing system. And the same publishing template package can contain both WebHelp and PDF customizations, so you can easily bundle and share both customizations as a single template. Each publishing template is a package that contains a descriptor file and various resources. The descriptor file controls the template package by defining the references to the other resources in the package. First, I'll introduce you to the built-in templates. I have a small data project about space exploration that I'll use for this video. I'll edit a WebHelp responsive transformation scenario. And you can see all the built-in templates in the First Templates tab. Notice there are some tags at the top of the pane to help you filter the templates and narrow your search. Now, to show you how to use one of the built-in templates as a starting point to create your own custom template, I'll select a very plain, simple template and I'll apply the transformation to show you what the WebHelp output looks like from my starting point. And ultimately, I want my output to look something like this. So, to begin my customization, I'll once again edit the transformation scenario, select the same built-in template, and I'll click the Save Template As button. This opens a template configuration dialog box. I'll enter a suitable name and description for the template, and I'll select a location where I want to save the exported package and choose a file name. The saved template is packaged into a zip archive, and since I want to modify some of its files, I first need to unzip it. I'll delete the zip file, and I'll add the newly created folder to my project so I can access the files directly in Oxygen. Now, remember I told you that each publishing template package contains a descriptor file, has an OPT file extension. So I'll open the descriptor file in Oxygen, and I'll make some structural changes according to what I want for my custom template. For example, I'll modify the tags that will be displayed in the transformation dialog box. You can have as many tags as you want, but for simplicity, I'll just include two. I'll keep the tiles, and I want the second one to be blue instead of gray, and I'll delete the other one. Next, I want to change the preview image that will be displayed in the transformation dialog box. I've also prepared some other image resources that I'll use later for my customization, so I'll create a folder inside my project and copy all of those image files there. Then I'll go back to the descriptor file and change the preview image to point to the correct image. I no longer need the existing default preview image, so I'll delete it. Then back in the descriptor file, notice there's also an online preview URL element. You could use this optional element to point to a URL of a published sample of your template, but I won't do that for this video, so I'll just delete it. Now I'll do some cosmetic customizations to the main page. First, I'll add a logo. I already added the logo image to my project, so now I just need to change the reference in the descriptor file to point to it. The logo element goes in the resources section. Now I want to transform it to see how it looks, but first I need to add my new template package to the gallery so I can choose it from the transformation dialog box. To do so, I simply click Configure Publishing Templates Gallery. Then I add the folder that contains my custom template. And after I click OK, I now see my newly created template is the first one displayed in the gallery. So I'll select it and apply the transformation. The logo looks fine, but now I want to customize the font and color scheme for the title, and I'll use CSS styling to do this. So back in Oxygen, I'll create a custom CSS that will act as a custom styling layer added on top of the default base CSS from the template I started with. Back in the descriptor file, I'll add a reference to the newly created CSS file after the reference to the base CSS. I should note that most of the elements in the descriptor file are optional, but one requirement is that at least one CSS file must be referenced. In my case, I'll use multiple CSS files. Then I'll switch back to the output and use my browser's inspect tool to identify the element I want to customize so that I can adjust the CSS rules that are being applied. In this case, it's the WH Publication Title class. Back in my custom CSS, I'll add a rule to adjust the color of the title. Then I'll import a custom Google font and set it as the font for my title and increase the font size. Now I'll transform it again to see how it looks. It looks good so far. So now I want to change the styling for some other components. So back to the CSS file, I'll add some more rules. Once again, I'll transform it to see the result. So far, so good, but I see one final customization that I want for my main page. I want to add a background image that will surround the search field. So I'll add the styling rule in my custom CSS. And I referenced an image that I added to the project earlier. So now I need to declare that image in the resources section back in the descriptor file so that the transformation process will copy it to the output folder and use it in the final output. I'll run the transformation scenario once again. And now I'm happy with my main page, so now I'll focus on the topic pages. This is what one of the topics looks like currently, and I want to adjust the styling for titles, color and borders for tables, and the padding for the related links section. Once again, I normally would use my browser's inspect tool to identify the elements, but for this video, I already did that behind the scenes, so I'll add my rules to the custom CSS. And I'll transform it again to see how these modifications look. And it looks good, so I've achieved everything I wanted for my WebHelp output. Remember that one of the benefits of using Oxygen Publishing templates is that the same template package can contain both WebHelp and PDF customizations. So now I'll show you how I can use the same template for PDF output, and it will reuse the same custom CSS styling while adding some additional styling specifically for printed media. First, back to the descriptor file. To use the template for PDF output, I need to add a new PDF section. Notice that I've used a different tag and different preview image for my PDF version, and the first two reference CSS files are the same as the WebHelp version. But I've added an additional custom CSS where I'll add the rules for printed media. That CSS file doesn't exist yet, But if I hold down the control key on my keyboard and left click that reference, Oxygen offers an option to quickly create that file. Now I'll run a PDF transformation and check the output. I edit the scenario called Did a Map to PDF based on HTML5 and CSS. And since I added a PDF section in the descriptor file, you see that my custom template is there in the gallery for this PDF transformation scenario. So I choose my template and apply the transformation. And I can see how my customization looks in the PDF output before adding additional styling. Before I continue with my customization, here's a tip for helping you to identify the elements you want to customize that are specific for printed media. This PDF transformation creates a merged mapping file in HTML5 format and adds it to the output folder. So if you go to the project view, find and expand the out folder, and right-click the merged HTML file, you can select Open With, and then System Application, and the merged mapping file is opened in your default browser. You can then use the browser's inspect tool to identify the elements from this HTML file. I mention this because headers, footers, and other CSS page media constructs are not shown when you inspect the output directly. Back to my customization. Now I'll add some rules to my custom CSS that are specifically for my PDF output. First, I want to add a background image and adjust the font size in the front page. Next, I'll add rules to modify the page headers and add the rocket logo in the top corner of the pages. And I want to hide the logo from the first page of each part of the publication. And I'll add rules to adjust the font size and color for text in certain headers. Now I'll rerun the transformation to see how it looks. I see that the front page has changed. The logo image is there. The headers look better. But I think the chapter titles could be improved. So I'll add rules to increase the size of the chapter numbers, move the titles below them, and adjust the styling of the fonts. I'll transform it again. And now I've achieved everything I wanted for my PDF output as well. So my custom template can now be used anytime I want to generate WebHelp or PDF output. The last thing I want to show you is a very simple way to share the custom templates with other members of your team. I'll go to Options, Preferences, and the Didda Publishing page. I'll switch the storage option at the bottom to Project Options, click OK, and now all I have to do is share my project with the rest of my team. For example, in my case, I would commit the change to the XPR file and the custom templates folder to our repository, and once my colleagues pulled the changes, they would have access to my custom template. So in this video, I've showed you how to create a custom template that can be used for both WebHelp and PDF output, and I've shown just a handful of basic CSS customizations that styled the output, but the possibilities are virtually limitless. For more information, see our documentation for customizing the WebHelp or PDF output. And this concludes the demonstration. As always, thank you for watching.